good? Is it recording? I think we good. What's going on, family? This your boy Chef V and this VZ. This your boy Chef V, aka Bobby, checking in. Just want to thank y'all for clicking on my page and checking out my content. In the event that you guys like anything that I'm sharing with you guys on tonight as far as my recipe goes, please feel free to like, comment, subscribe. Go to my main page and click on that link in my bio and subscribe to me, please. This is my very first video, so I'm trying to make a success of this thing. So please, yes, help a brother out. Like I said, my name is Chef B, aka Bobby. I am a Virginia resident by way of Fly City, Michigan. Flint, Michigan, that's right, you heard it. However, I am down here in Virginia right now for work. But yes, I'm a Michigan resident, baby. I know they got some crazy snow back there right about now, 8 to 10 inches. We're supposed to be getting some tomorrow, so let's pray that we don't. So anyway... Once again, thank you guys for checking out my page and checking out my content. The whole purpose of this page, obviously, is to just share some of the recipes that I make in my kitchen on a daily basis. Some healthy things that I like to make as I like to lead, or at least try to lead, a healthy and clean eating lifestyle. My aunt actually was the person who really encouraged me to do this and to really get my personality and get my face out there. So I just want to give a big shout out to her, Africa Serene Shackleford. She's amazing. And so just thanking you for encouraging me and inspiring me to do something like this for sure. Tonight we're going to be making a very simple meal, nothing too major, just because this is my first video and I don't want to overload you guys with content. However, as we go into our weekly videos, as I'm going to try to do this weekly, we will get more complex in the things that we prepare and all that jazz. The whole thing that brought this about was obviously quarantine. Corona 2020 definitely didn't cut anybody any favors, made things very difficult for all of us out there. It's been a very, very hard time. However, you know, it's definitely been a great time to really get clarity and really kind of become one with yourself and figure out what your purpose is and what it is that you want to do in life and where it is that you want to go. I know that for me, cooking has been a great outlet. It really is like a source of peace for me. I feel a source of calm when I'm cooking and preparing a meal, even though it's just for myself. It's just something that feels good. It makes you feel good about cooking, you know, versus just getting takeout every single night. Takeout, that shit adds up, bruh. So taking the time out to prepare a meal that could last you for days is much better than getting a $20 meal, $25 meal that's only gonna last you for the night. You know what I'm saying? So that was the whole purpose behind me kind of trying to become a media content creator. And just wanting to share some of my healthy recipes with you guys and just hoping that you guys could adopt them into your own lives and hopefully they work for you as well. So, like I said, tonight we are going to be making our very first dish, and that is going to be a cheesy asparagus casserole. Sounds right. Sounds good, right? I'm very excited about it. Very, very excited about it. It's my very first time making it. But yes, I'm going to be making that tonight along with a pan-seared salmon fillet. Two of those, actually. My very first time making those, too. So we'll see how this goes and see how it comes out. So, first and foremost, I want to start with your ingredients that you're going to need for your cheesy asparagus casserole. First and foremost, you're going to need 1.5 pounds of asparagus, okay? You want to make sure that when you get your asparagus that you cut your woody brown part off here. You really don't want any of those ends, obviously, in your food as it bakes. So make sure you obviously rinse these off and cut these guys off. Let me rewind. I'm sorry, as I'm going into ingredients already, and ain't even walk through my kitchen. So something that I do first and foremost when I come into my kitchen before I get ready to cook or prepare anything is you gotta wash your hands, man. It's definitely a big thing right now. Corona is definitely real, so we really gotta make sure. Oh man, we definitely gotta make sure that we are continuing to. I'm back. I got soap in my eye. But yes, we gotta make sure that we are continuing to protect ourselves and keep ourselves clean. Making sure that we're washing our hands constantly and daily, especially before we are preparing food and before we get ready to eat food. We definitely wanna make sure that we are always washing our hands. That's something that my mother and my grandmother and my father especially instilled in me and my siblings growing up. And you gotta make sure you wash your hands before you get in that kitchen because you don't know where your hands be. So yes, definitely make sure you take the time out to wash your hands. Oh shit. Sorry, I think I got some soap in my eye. Oh shit, man. Okay. Yep, I'm pretty sure that I did. But we gonna G this thing on out and keep it moving, right? You wash your hands. Something that I'm really big on in my kitchen is disinfecting wipes. So I wipe down all of my counters and my sink with these disinfecting wipes before I start cutting or doing anything in the kitchen. I've already done it, obviously, before I started the video, because I already have things cut up, obviously, but just take one of these boys off, maybe sometimes two, and the next one, just wipe down your counters. Just because you don't know if you're going to be cutting on that counter or putting anything on that counter. So you really want to make sure that you wipe everything down. Sometimes for my sink, I'll use like a totally separate one. But either way it goes, you want to make sure that you're disinfecting before you cut anything or do anything in your kitchen after you've washed your hands. All right. With that being said, let's get into some ingredients and talk about those and what we need and all that jazz. Y'all hear that Durand and Ari Lennox playing in my background, boo? Stuck. Love that song. It's my song. Yes. Neither here nor there. Not talking about that right now. So, yeah. So, with this, we are making, once again, that cheesy asparagus casserole. So, what we need is 1.5 pounds of asparagus. Once again, you're going to want to cut off the woody tips before you put them into the oven with your baking and all that jazz. So yes, you need those. You're also going to need 1 small onion, thinly sliced. You can slice these up as small as you would like or as big as you would like, but you want to make sure that they are thin for sure. Okay. You're also going to need 1/2 cup of broth. It could be chicken broth, it could be beef broth, veggie broth, whatever broth you prefer. It could be either of those things. 8 ounces of softened cream cheese, because you'll need this to mix up and get the texture and consistency that you want. I don't have that out right now, actually. We have 1/2 cup of grated Parmesan cheese, okay? We have 1 whole cup of mozzarella shredded cheese, and also got some Asiago in there as well. Okay. We got garlic cloves in here, or if you didn't want to use garlic cloves, you could also do 1 to 2 tablespoons of garlic powder. Either or would suffice. I'm a huge fan of both garlic and garlic powder, so I'll probably end up using both, to be completely honest with you. Okay. You also want to make sure that you have 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt, and then also some black pepper as well, which I naturally put into an actual bowl. 1 teaspoon of Italian seasoning. That's always really awesome and tasty. The crushed red pepper flakes are optional. You can use them if you want to. I like a little kick sometimes, so I'm definitely gonna use some on mine. And then last but not least, you have some freshly chopped parsley here that you'll also kind of use for garnish after you've baked, or you could also put it in before you bake as well, okay? So those are pretty much all of your ingredients that you need for the asparagus casserole. Over here in my bowl, I got my filets pretty much just kind of thawing out a little bit before I get ready to put them in. But I'm going to do one thing at a time. I'm not going to do anything with the filets as of yet. What I am going to do right now, though, is I do want my... Sorry, someone's texting me. I do like my asparagus to be a little bit more tender. I don't really want it to be hard or crunchy or anything like that. So I am going to boil it for 2 minutes in a half thing of water in a pot just before I get ready to put it into the oven. So how's everybody been doing out there? Crazy time we living in, right? Kind of, sort of. But it's all good, though. We are all covered by the blood of Jesus, so we are going to be fine. Okay. Alright, y'all. So now I'm just getting ready to cut the ends off of my asparagus. So as you can see, I'm going to be cutting off this little end right here. And it's total personal preference. If you want to keep it on, you can. You don't have to cut it off. I just know that for me, I like to. So I'm going to. But once you cut it off, it's pretty much going to look like that. And you just drop them into your water. Now, mind you, once again, you're going to let these boil just for 2 minutes before you get ready to put them into the oven with all their garnishing and all that jazz on. I got two bundles of these and I feel like I only really need to use one. I think I'm just going to use all of these. Because I need this meal to last me for at least 2 days. So yes, we going to roll with two bundles. So versus me having 1.5 pounds, I had 2 pounds. Sorry, I'm quiet, y'all. I be in the zone when I be cutting because I'm a real klutz and I be done cut my fucking finger off. So, yeah. Ooh, not Mary. Man, this is some old school Mary. I love it. You Gotta Believe off the My Life album. I love everything about that CD, but this is my song. Just rinsing off my asparagus right now. Sorry.
Trust me.
So your green beans, your asparagus should pretty much look like that after you have cut them off and washed them off and all that jazz. Okay, so now we're going to put some more water in here, and then we are going to let these boil for 2 minutes. So what I'm getting ready to do right now is cut this Mary down. I'm getting ready to mix my softened cream cheese and my chicken broth into a mixture, because that then will be poured over the asparagus before I put it into the oven, okay? All right, guys, so there is the softened cream cheese. I'm gonna go ahead and pour in the chicken broth, and then I'm going to go ahead and stir this and get a consistency going. Now, if you have a mixer at home, obviously that's gonna work a lot better than some good old elbow grease. Now, provided elbow grease can get the job done, it's just gonna take a little bit longer. But yes, if you have a mixer at home, I would definitely encourage using that guy instead. Okay, so I'm pretty sure it's probably been about 2 minutes, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut my asparagus off. Should be a little bit softer than it was. And once again, that's optional. You don't have to do that necessarily. I just want my asparagus to be a little bit tender when I get ready to eat it. So therefore, I put the extra step in there at the beginning. But that's totally optional. Okay, so right now I'm just mixing up my mixture of, not asparagus, my mixture of softened cream cheese and chicken broth. Okay. I feel like I should be talking to y'all while I'm doing this, because I don't want to bore y'all, obviously. But it is what it is. If I was cooking with someone, maybe I could be having conversation with them. But hey, it is what it is, right? Okay. All right. So as you can see, I still have a few lumps in mine, and that's just because I didn't use an actual mixer. I only have a spoon that I'm using. So once again, if you use a mixer, you'll probably end up getting a smoother finish than versus having any lumps in yours. But I do have a couple of lumps left in mine, but hey, that's going to be what it is. I'm not making a pie, or I ain't making a cake. it's going to be just fine. So yes. If you want to spend some more time though doing it, you totally can. It's totally your choice, because it's your meal. But you want to do that for a little while, and once again, just try to get out as many lumps as you possibly can. And once again, this is going to go on top of the asparagus before you put it into the oven, once you've gotten all of your other ingredients and everything put onto it. What's going on? All right, so next we are going to go ahead and get this asparagus put into the oven. All right, so first and foremost, you wanna go ahead and get your baking sheet, not your baking sheet, with your baking pan, whatever that may be. This is the one that I am rolling with on today. Okay, you want to spray it with a cooking oil, or you could also use a cooking oil as well. I'm a huge fan of canola. So I am going to just put a little bit of this in the bottom of my pan here. Not a lot. And then I'm gonna do it how my grandma used to do it. Roll that thing around until you get the oil all over the pan. Thank y'all for tuning in. I really, really do appreciate it. I hope that this is interesting to you guys and you come back to check me out for next week's dish, whatever that may be. Okay, so after we've done that, all right, we're gonna go ahead and get this asparagus put into the oven. Or you know what? I'm actually going to go ahead and, yep. Oh man, I'm excited. This is gonna be really good. Or at least I think so. Hell, anybody gotta eat it with me. So that's the good thing about being able to cook for yourself. You ain't gotta worry about nobody else judging your cooking, even though I know my cooking is pretty good. Like, no lie about that at all. Sometimes I wish you knew. Hey. But I disguise the truth. I say I'm happy, but I'm still stuck on us. Doesn't mind play this game too. Yes. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and put all of my toppings on. So we're gonna start with my onions, which I'm not sure where they are. Putting in the Italian seasoning right now. My red pepper chili flakes. Sea salt. Pepper. I'm a huge fan of pepper, bro. left pepper. Now don't you go damn crazy now. One of my mom's ex-boyfriends, when we were kids, used to always say that. I'm just like, this man is old, super. We're gonna go ahead and get our garlic put in here. Love me some garlic. That was our oven going off, telling us that it's time to put it in or cut it off. FYI, you should be setting your oven to 450. This is only gonna bake or cook for about 15 to 20 minutes, not long at all. It's a very quick meal. It's just taking me a longer time, obviously, because I'm explaining everything to you guys as I go along, but for the most part, it doesn't take that long. It's a very quick meal. Everything with me takes a long time. I just like taking my time, to be honest with you. I'm not a huge fan of rushing. So yeah. Let me show you a little bit of what I got going on over here. So just in case you're wondering. I don't think I can flip this. I can't. All right, so that's pretty much what we're looking like as of right now. So that's with all of, well, most of our ingredients added in. So we have our onions, our garlic, our red pepper, our Italian seasoning. Probably gonna add a little bit of Mrs. Dash in there as well, just to have. Red pepper flakes. All that right now is just kind of marinating and mixing in that. I'm gonna add the cheese here in a second, okay? It look good though, huh? It do. I like it. Now we're going to take our cream cheese and what was it? Cream cheese and broth mixture, and we're gonna pour it over. Yummy, 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 right? Expecting for it to, man. I'm sure that it will. You want to try to get as much of that filling out, or that whatever you want to call it, out as you possibly can. We are not wasteful over here. All right, and then once you get that on, then you're going to take your grated Parmesan cheese. Go ahead and just pour that over. Okay. And then take your mozzarella and Asparagus shredded. Thank you. All right, and then lastly, I'm gonna go ahead and top it with some parsley flakes. Making it pretty, a little garnish. And that, my friends, and that is what it looks like going into the oven. Looks really, really good. I'm excited to eat it, to be honest with you. But yes, we're gonna go ahead and place this in the oven once again on 450, and we're gonna put it in for 15 to 20 minutes. So it's 10:07 right now, so we're gonna come back and check it around 10:27. And then, yeah, we'll go from there. But yes, that is the way we're looking going into the oven, guys. And boy, cooking, yeah, baby. Look good, huh? So you can definitely tell this is my first video because I already cut into the casserole without showing y'all how it looked after. But either way it goes, this is the way that it came out. Came out pretty well for the most part. I feel like next time I might end up trying something a little different, but I feel like for the most part it's beautiful, tastes good, so I'm excited about that. And then yeah, there's the plate. So yes, I definitely think that it is going to be yummy for sure.